Hey you guys, and welcome to another video. So today nga po is May 20, 2019, and today is my scheduled na enrollment or magpapa-enroll sa law school. And I will be bringing you with me sa enrollment. By the way, I'm Jeremiah and I upload law school and law student-related vlogs. If you are new to this channel, please don't forget to click subscribe and click the notification bell sa tabi ng subscribe. Or you can just click here in a circle dyan sa my corner. Okay? So, let's get to the video. Okay, so today nga po is my enrollment and yun nga, I'll be bringing you with me sa enrollment ko and today is May 20, today is Lunes and may work ako but I had to file a leave for this one because wala lang akong ibang day for my enrollment. My vacant kasi na day is weekends lang and of course, wala namang enrollment pag weekend so nag-leave ako for today. And yes, I'll be going now to the law school kung saan ako mag-enroll. By the way, I'll be bringing with me my friend, si Francis. You'll be meeting Francis later. And background about ni Francis. Francis is one of my closest friends na classmate ko from high school. Like, we were classmates since first year high school hanggang gumaduate kami ng high school. So, why Francis? Because si Francis, may, I think, 20 units na siya ng law. He decided i-proceed yung law niya dito sa school kung saan ako mag-enroll ngayon. Kinuha niya yung pre-law niya sa school kung saan ako mag-enroll ngayon ng law. That's why, mas convenient and mas malaking tulong si Francis ngayon pag sinama ko siya sa enrollment. Because he knows the school, he knows the place, he knows the offices kung saan ipoprocess yung enrollment, and he knows yung mga processes doon na hindi ko rin alam. Okay, so you'll be meeting Francis later. So, tara! By the way guys, please excuse my because later pag nasa school na tayo, I won't be using my digicam, I'll be using my phone sa pagbi-video because that's a new place and parang natakot ako mag-use ng camera sa school, baka pagalitan ako. Okay? In the next videos, in the next clips, you will notice na medyo lower yung quality ng video.
Okay, so lunch break and yeah, I'm here with Francis. So, Alex and Helmet later.
Hello. Hello. Musika tiga ni.
Bantay ha.
Ah, ano siya? Ay, touch me. Ah. So, umuna ilan nagiwa to yung system nga old.
Tubang ya, tubang, tubang. Dili. Kau tanya dong asa. Karena sama kau. Nama kau tu yang sa, kung sa main pakai nato saya murag specific nga office pun yang kau aga ini. Kalimut kau. Kalimut aku sila kau. So ya dari oi kanang plug, plug. So how cool is that? Your school. Rekorto, rekorto. Dapat i-show pa man mo ang money na anak mo. Yee, excited na siya. Ay, pakita ha. Makuha na dahil. Pata na daw, makuha ha. Ipakita mo ang resibo.
Saw kay mo ani to subos sa mas second floor mo no.
So kadaw mi sa sao.
Okay, nga nisa niya.
Okay, so kakatapos na namin sa enrollment and yes, I'm officially enrolled sa law school. So it's already 4 in the afternoon. We started at 9 o'clock. Medyo mahaba yung process pero enjoy.
Hi again, and yes, we're in the house na, nakakawin na ako, tapos yun na nga, nakapag-enroll na nga ako, and now I'm officially a law student, yes! So kanina nga, mention ko kanina, nag-start kami ng enrollment ng 9 in the morning, tapos medyo marami kasing tao dun sa ano, sa may registrar, dun kami natagalan ni Francis sa registrar. Because you guys, remember this one, if you are going to enroll yourselves sa law school, of course, they will have to verify your units sa pre-law nyo. If your pre-law na units are able to meet the minimum requirement na units for law. For example, sa English, dapat you must have at least 18 units sa English sa yung pre-law, which means from first year na college hanggang fourth year college mo, if you're going to total that one, dapat 18 units siya lahat sa English. As well as sa math, dapat 18 units din. And last is sa social studies, dapat 18 units. Yun yung requirement. Tapos, dahil dun, nagka-problema ako sa units. Why? Because nung verify na ni ma'am registrar yung sa TOR ko, she found out na I have lacking units in English and sa social studies. Ayos ng mathematics ko, I was able to meet the 18 unit requirement. Pero sa English guys, kailangan ko ng isang English pa na subject. I only had 16 units of English sa pre-law ko na course. Pero di ba wala namang 2 unit na subject na English. So I need to take 1 additional na English para makumpleto ko yung 18 unit na requirement sa English. And sa social studies, may kulang ako na 3 social studies na subject para ma-meet ko yung 18 units na requirements. Sa pre-law ko kasi, yung subjects ko lang is Life of Rizal tsaka Philippine History. And those only constitute 6 units. 6 or 7 units. So malaki pa kulang ko for 18 units. That's why I was advised by the registrar that I have to take 3 social studies na subject and 1 additional English subject. Dapat kong kunin yung subjects, yung lacking units every summer. So dapat daw makompleto ko yun within the 4 year na stay ko sa school. Before ako gagraduate ng law, dapat makompleto ko na yung 4 na lacking subjects ko. Yun yung sabi sa akin ng registrar. And she was kind enough to accept me since ayos naman yung ibang units. Kaya natagalan kami sa registrar. Ito lang, i-add ko lang guys. Kasi nga, since enrolled na ako and yung mga, siguro may mga iba nanonood na you are planning to enroll for conditional and I think that the term is discretionary enrollment. So ito nga, if you know, if you notice, if nabasa nyo na to before, may dalawa ngayon na klase ng enrollees. Yun sa mga yung conditional tsaka discretionary. Una guys, yung pinalabas yung TRO ng LEB regarding dun sa pag-lift ng effectivity ng PhilSAT, may pinalabas sila na conditional. Ang conditional enrollment po are for those yung hindi nakapag-take ng PhilSAT, tapos yung nag-take ng PhilSAT pero hindi nakapasa. Those are the students who are going to enroll na conditional. So what is conditional enrollment? Yung conditional enrollment is tatanggapin ka for this SEM, for first SEM, na as a regular law student. Basta, you have to make sure na in the next PhilSAT exam, you have to make sure that you pass the PhilSAT. If mapasa mo yung PhilSAT, then you'll be considered a regular student for second SEM. But, if you are not able to pass the PhilSAT or if you are not able to take the PhilSAT by September, then the school or the LAB will no longer accept you as a regular student sa second SEM. Yung conditional, you have to apply for conditional enrollment and dapat pa siyang ipadala sa Manila sa office ng LAB para aprobahan ng office. Yung naalala ko, parang ilang days 3 to 4 days or 3 to 5 days bago nila ipadala yung reply if you're approved for conditional enrollment. So yun yung magiging conditional na enrollment. Next, yung discretionary naman na enrollment is, ito ha, bago lang siya pinalabas ng PhilSAT na website. According to them, those takers, those aspiring law students who took the PhilSAT last April 2019, hindi nakapasa, hindi nakamit sa required na 55% na passing, but their rating is hindi bumaba sa 45%, that's 45 to 55%. yung kuha nila, then they can be considered as discretionary enrollees. Anong ibig sabihin ng discretionary enrollees? Discretionary enrollees are, you'll be allowed to enroll to a law school, but it's under the discretion of the school if they're going to accept you as a regular student from first year hanggang fourth year graduation. But still, you have to apply that one sa LAB as discretionary enrollees. Yun yung intindihan ko guys sa discretionary enrollees, parang memo from the PhilSat and from the LAB page. If you want to know more about discretionary enrollment tsaka yung conditional na enrollment, I think I'm gonna link that one below. So I think that's it for today, and yun na nga, I'm just so happy na I'm now an official law student from now on. Today is May 20, 2019, and yun, I'm so excited for June next month kasi yung start ng classes namin is June 13, so after the Independence Day hindi pa kami kasama sa August na opening, so by June 13 yung classes namin. Yun lang guys for today. So if you have your comments, so kayo, anong balita sa enrollment? Please balitaan niyo ako kung anong nangyari sa enrollment. Please comment that one below kung sino nakapag-enroll. Kasi guys, we're batchmates. So I want to know if you're officially enrolled sa law school. So please again, comment that one below. Magkumustahan tayo guys. And yes, shout out pala sa lumalaki nating family, lumalaki na itong tribe. Please comment everything below if you have questions, if you have suggestions, if you want to ask something, please guys, comment that below. Again, if you are new to this channel, please don't forget to click subscribe. Kasi guys, we are growing family here. We are a growing tribe, and I'm hoping na mas lalaki pa tayo. So, I will see you in my next video. Bye!